Welcome to part 3 of my series on QMK firmware. Get yourself up to speed by watching the previous episodes where we set up our PC ready to build and flash any of the dozens of keyboards that support QMK. In this episode, we'll look at the basics of customizing a layout. The QMK supports a massive number of keyboards, so chances are that yours is there somewhere. The easiest way to get started with a layout of your own is to use an existing one as a base. Make a new folder in the layout section of your chosen keyboard. Then find a layout that you think will be a good place to start. Copy the files from that layout into your new folder. There are a few files that you're going to need. Some are optional and not all will be in the folder you copy from. The Keymap file is the one that we'll use to build our layout. The rules file is where we can toggle some QMK features when we compile. The README file is where you explain a little bit about your layout. You should copy over the same files for whichever layout you're using as your base. You may or may not have a README or a config file. Just copy whatever's there and we'll figure out the rest later. Open the file named Keymap. Depending on the layout you've chosen as your base, it might look completely baffling. The file has three sections: the definitions, the key map, and then custom functions. We're just going to deal with the basic key codes and layers in the key map section first. This key map has two layers that have been named BL, the base layer, and FL, a function layer. Naming them makes it easier for us to understand which layer we're talking about. Feel free to give your layers different names. Choosing something that not only makes sense to you, but to anyone else who might look at the key map. These parts that look more like a keyboard layout won't be read by QMK since they've been formatted as comments and are just for us humans. A single line comment is a double forward slash, and a multi-line comment is opened with a forward slash and an asterisk, and closed by reversing those symbols. You don't have to include these visual representations, but many people find them helpful. I'd suggest doing that once you're happy with your layout. Always comment on what things are and what they are meant to do for your own benefit and again for others who might try to use your key map or try and help you if it won't compile. Here are the key codes that QMK will send to your computer. The basic key codes are pretty obvious, but the documentation is an essential resource. At the end of each row, there's a backslash. This key, MOFL, will trigger a momentary layer that will make FL the active layer as long as the key is pressed. If I want the layer to toggle on or off, then I'd need to change the key code to TGFL. So FL doesn't have much on it other than backlight or, if it's present, RGB control. The lines here mean that key code is transparent and will therefore output the key code of the next lowest active layer that isn't transparent. So when I press my function key, I still have access to all my numbers and most of my alphas. It's important to remember this when you set up your layers or you'll have some weird stuff happening. This layout is lacking a lot of things and probably isn't the best starting point, but it'll suffice for the purpose of this guide. The F keys are here for some reason, no arrow keys. It's a pretty sorry default, to be honest. Let's fix that. Now I've got arrow keys, an F row, in a sensible place, and I've moved caps lock to the function layer. That means I can put backspace in my preferred position. I'd suggest that you don't start adding multiple layers and advanced functions until you've compiled a basic key map first that you can successfully flash to your board. If you're not confident you can make sense of any error messages that crop up, you'll be in for a very frustrating experience if you make a ton of changes at once, as will anyone who tries to help you. In part 3, I'll flash my new key map to this Satan G860. I'd probably better build it at some point.